Good morning everyone. In our previous video we have studied regarding the static data member and static member function, which is the most IMP question as a exam point of view. In our today's session we are going to discuss three topics. Number one, array of object. Number two, object as function arguments. And number three, friend functions. Again, in this session, friend function is very much important topic. Generally, it may ask in the 5-mark questions in the theoretical exam. So, be careful. Let us start with our today's session. Example of array of object has include iostream.h, has include conio.h. We are going to implement class employee, so class emp, then integer number character nm of 15. Over here I have taken array. You can also take pointer instead of array. If you want to allocate the memory dynamically, at that time you can use the concept of pointer. Then public keyword. So it means that these three variables are private variable of employee class. So this variable cannot be accessed outside the class, but definitely it can be used with the public method of the same class. This concept we have already seen in our previous videos, right? At the time of private member function or private variables of class, at that time we have seen this concept. Now I'm going to create one method called getData. In getData we are going to input values of three variables. Enter value for number, cin, no, cout. Enter name. Cin, nm, cout. Enter salary. Cin salary. So using getData you are able to input values of three variable called number, name and salary. Now we are going to create method display to display whatever the values we have entered through the keyboard. Number variable, cout / n, name, nm variable, cout / n, salary variable. Now we are going to write the body of void main, clr scr and get ch. Now what is our concept? We are going to create the program on array of object. Now what is object? When you want to access the method of class, at that time you can use the concept of object, right? So with the help of object of that class I am able to access the method or variable outside the class. So basically we are going to do like this: employee e1 comma e2 comma E3. If I want to call these functions three times, at that time I need to create three objects of the same class. And now I can do E1.getData. This we have already done in our previous session, right? So this is the repetition only. I am going to explain you the changes, why we use the concept of array of object. Again, get data and E3.display. So in our previous video we have performed programs like, based on this we have created three object of the employee class, say for example over here. Then with the help of E1 I have used and called get data and display. For the object E2, get data and display, and for the object E3 I have called get data and display. But what is the disadvantage of doing this type of object or creating object in this way? See, the memory allocation for each object should be different in such cases. Why? Because even the location, or we can say address of E1 would be different. Similarly, E2 should be stored in some other location. Similarly, there is a memory occupied by the E3 is on the different location. So these three objects are stored in the different locations. But suppose I want to store it in the same memory location, right, on the constant memory location, at that time I can use the concept of array. Here E is the object, and I am going to create the array of object. Over here I have taken 2. That means I am able to store, or I am able to call three functions, these functions three times, that is with the help of E0, because we people know that array index start with the 0. So E of 0, then E of 1 and E of 2. In this way I am able to access the method of employee class. But only the difference between by calling a object in this way as well as by the array of object is what? The value which has been called by this type of array of object, it is stored in the same memory location. But when you are going to use the, or we can say create the object in this way, at that time it refers to the different memory location. So now let us make a changes in the program. You just need to write E of 0 for accessing the first element of object, then E1, then E2. So in this way you can call the methods of employee class, but it is stored at the same memory location. Let us save the program by p28.c++. Let me run the given code. Enter value for number. We need to input name and we need to input salary. Again, for the second time you need to enter. Why? Because we have called these functions three times. So again I am going to call 2 Radha, and salary would be suppose 6000, and again 3 Krishna, and salary would be 7000. So in this way it will print on the screen. One more thing we need to perform is, when I am going to call this function again and again, I need to use backslash n code so that output would be proper. And one more thing you can perform over here, that first of all call all the get data method, and then call the display method to get proper output. Now let us save code. We will get proper output. Enter Second number, name is Radha. Salary would be 6,000. Third case, Krishna. And salary would be of 7,000. So you will get proper output on the screen. I just have make a changes in the code. I just applied backslash n code in the get data to get proper output. And in this way, you can call the functions of class with the help of array of objects. As we people know that array index should be start with the 0. So over here, E of 0, with the help of that I am able to access get data method, which is declared inside the class. Similarly, first of all I have completed the function call of get data, and then I have called display function with the array of object of class. Only the difference is what, when you use the concept of array of object, in such cases the memory allocation for the object would be in the sequence, or it occupies constant memory allocation for each object. So this is the first program of our today's session. See, if you have cleared the previous session's videos and you have learned the programs, in that case only you are able to understand the advanced concept of C++. Now next topic is example of object as function argument. Now what is the concept? We are going to pass the object into the argument of any function. So we are going to create any function with the help of passing argument of object. So if I want to create the object, at that time I need to have a class. That is the compulsory requirement. So let us include header files first, iostream.h and conio.h. Then class, my topic is object as argument, so I am going to create class obj_arg. In that I am going to declare three variables, integer m1, m2 and total. From the variable name only you are able to get that my program is related with the mark. I need to input mark of two subject, and based on that I need to calculate the total. Now void display now remember one thing, that I have not used or we can say I have not declared display function inside the obj_arg class. That means this function does not belong with the class, or it is not the part of class. So this function we can call directly, no need to use the object of obj_arg class. This function can be called directly, and this function, in this function we are going to pass object as function argument. So first of all, what is the name of class? obj_arg. So that name of class I need to pass over here, and then I have passed object name o1. So this type of function, which type of UDF is this? This is without return and with argument. So this is with argument, without return value. Now o1 dot total, I am going to explain the code, but first let me note down the code. First o1 dot m2. Now see out. Backslash n mark 1 is o1 dot m1. See out. Backslash n mark 2 is o1 dot m2. See out. Backslash n total is o1 dot total. So UDF is created. Now void main. In void main we are going to write CLR SER and get CH function. Now I need to pass two values of variable m1 equals to 70 and m2 equals to 70, say for example. Now object arg a1 equals to m1 comma m2 and display a1. Let me save the code first, then I will explain what I have written and in what way program is executed. Now let us run the code first, so output would be proper in such cases. Now I am going to explain the given code. What is our concept? We have to create one function with argument, and that function contains object as a argument. That is my concept. So first of all, I need to create one class. I have created class with name object arg. I have used public keyword to make the following variables public: m1, m2 and total. Three variables I have declared as a public, and that variable are a part of object arg class. Now outside the class, see, this display function is not a part of class. How can I say that? See over here, I have not mentioned that void display I am going to create in future. That is number one thing. Number two, if display function would be a part of class, in such cases I need to declare it outside the class in this way, with the name of class and with the help of scope resolution operator. But this is a individual function, that means it is not a part of class and you can call these functions directly. One more thing, see, this UDF is which type of UDF? It is a without return with argument UDF. Now our concept is object. Object, how can I create? With the help of name of class. So I have created object arg, that is the name of class, and I have created object of that class within the function argument. Now what happens over here? See, with the help of O1, I am able to access public member of, or we can say public variable of object class. So O1.total equals to O1.m1 plus O1.m2. Because I have declared this variable as a public variable, I can access this variable outside the class. Suppose if I am going to declare this variable as a private variable, in such cases I am not able to declare, or I am not able to use it outside the class. So be careful, you need to make these variables as a public variable. Now o1.total, o1.m1 and o1.m2. So addition should be stored inside the total, and this is a printing statement. I want to print mark 1, mark 2 and total on the screen. So display function will display the mark 1, the number value which is stored inside mark 1, mark 2 and total. Now in what way this function is called? Remember one thing, I have taken two variables over here, that is integer m1 equals to 70 and m2 equals to 70. Now I have created object of arg class, and I have stored, I can write like this, object arg a1 equals to m1 comma m2. See, in the very beginning session of this particular chapter, we have learned three different ways to pass values inside the class, right? We have seen in the very first video of this unit, we have seen three different ways using that we can pass values to the structure. Same programs, we have converted it into the class, and there are again three ways to pass value of class variables. So that is one of the way using which you can pass the value of object A1. So A1 dot M1 equals to 70 and A1 dot M2 equals to 70. If you people get a confusion between the name of object, at that time you can also use O1 over here, because the life of this O1 is up till this block and life of this O1 would be up till the void display. So you can take same variable, but right now I have used it as a separate variable. So object A1 over here, A1 dot M1 equals to 70 and A1 dot M2 equals to 70. Now what I have passed, see, this function is called the UDF with argument without return. So over here I have passed whole object A1. A1 contains what? A1 contains A1 dot M1 and A1 contains A1 dot M2. So both the values I have passed with the object A1. And remember one thing, display is not a part of class. That's why I have called these functions directly. Now when I call this display function, the focus is going inside the display function. Now I have passed object A1 over here, it is cached using O1. Remember one thing, that see, if I passed integer value over here, suppose I am going to pass display integer number equals to 5, and suppose I am going to pass integer number, consider this case, I am going to explain why I have passed A1 over here. So consider these two lines, what I performed, integer number, so number is a integer type variable, and what is the value of number? 5. So we are going to call display function with an integer argument. So when you create display function, at that time you need to declare it as a number, right? So be careful. Suppose if you are going to pass number, in such cases display function must contain one integer variable. Suppose if you are going to pass two values, m1 comma m2, right? So over here you need to have two integers to catch. This is the basic functions which we have already discussed in C language, right? It is repeated over here. So now we are going to make advanced programs. So over here A1 is the object. So as a when I call display method, at that time I must have one object to catch these values. So over here we have O1. Now we can say that A1 equals to O1. So whatever the values of A1, that would be the values of O1 now. So O1 dot total equals to O1 dot M1. What is the value of O1 dot M1 now? I can write instead of A1, I can write O1 dot M1, that is 70. So 70 plus 70 would be 140. It is stored inside O1 dot total, and that three values I am going to print on the screen. But this is not the concept. Only the concept is what we are going to pass object as a function argument. So remember one thing, when you are going to pass object as a function argument, at that time you need to have the object to catch whatever the values you have passed from void main, you need to catch it over here. Now let me remove the code first. Now suppose if I don't want to take these two integer values, right, or I don't want to take these variables, at that time you can directly pass the values over here. It will produce the same output. if you don't want to allocate the memory of variable. In such cases also you can avoid integer m1 equals to 70 and m2 equals to 70. You can directly pass the values of variable with the help of object in this way. So this is the second program of our today's session, that is called object as function argument. Now one more program we are going to perform based on the object as function argument to make you more clear regarding the topic. Example of object as function argument, that is the second program of this topic, has include iostream.h, has include conio.h. I am going to create class test. Integer x. Public keyword. Remember one thing, that x is our private variable, so we cannot call it outside the class test. Now void get data, integer a. Get data is what? With argument, without return function. Over here I am going to write x equals to a. Void display. Cout. / n. Addition is x. One more processing statement I have mentioned inside the class, that is void sum test t1 comma test t2. I am going to explain the given code, so don't worry regarding that. X equals to t1 dot x plus t2 dot x. Now void main clrscr and get ch. Let us create three objects of test class, t1, t2 and t3. Why? Because we have to perform integer a comma b comma c. C equals to a plus b. This is the logic to perform addition of any number. Over here with the help of object I am going to perform addition. So I have taken three objects of test class. Now t1 dot get data into bracket I am going to pass 20. Again with the help of t2 I am going to call get data again. I am going to pass 10 inside that. T3 dot sum into bracket t1 comma t2 and t3 dot display. First of all let me save the program p30.c++. Now let us run the code first. Yes, it produced proper output. Now let me remove the given code. Now remember, over here test class contains three different objects, t1, t2 and t3. Now test class have four properties, we can say. Number one, variable x, and three methods. So all the three functions have equal rights to access that property. Over here all the three variables, or we can say all the three objects, has individual x variable to access them. Now what happens, I have called t1 dot get data and inside that what I have passed, 20. So it will call get data function And what I have passed with the argument, I have passed value 20. So what happens, integer a equals to 20 in such cases. After that, what is the name of our local variable? That is variable x. So now x equals to a. What is the value of a? That is 20. So now x equals to 20. So now, but remember one thing, that this function I have called with the object of t1 class. So t1 dot x equals to 20. Now t2 dot get data, with the help of that I have passed 10. Again this function is called 10. The value of a is 10 in such cases, right? Now over here x equals to a, and now what is the value of x? That is 10, but this is for the object t1 and this is for the object t2. So now t2 dot x contains value 10. Now what happens, I have called t3 dot sum, so it will call sum function. Inside that, what I have passed, t1 comma t2. Now t1 contains 20 and t2 contains 10. So t1 dot x contains 20 and t2 dot x contains 10. So we have passed object over here. So remember one thing, when you pass object of class, at that time you need to take, or you need to have object variable to catch the given value. So over here test t1, test t2. Why I have, see, you cannot declare test t1 comma t2 in this way. You cannot call it. Why? Because in the function we have used like this only, integer m1 comma integer m2, right? This is the correct way to call the function. So remember one thing, that you must need to declare the name of class over here and you must need to specify it over here also. Now t1 dot x, what is the value of t1 dot x? That is 20. Plus t2 dot x, what is the value of t2 dot x? 10. So 20 plus 10 is what? 30. But with the help of t3, we have called this function sum. So what is the, see, I have not specified that this x is for the t3. Why? Because I have called my sum function with the help of this t3 object. So the value of t3 dot x would be sum of these two objects. So 30 would be there in the t3 dot x. Now what we people call t3 dot display, so t3 dot display addition is and x, but what is the value of x? In with the help of t3 object I have called display method, so it will print t3 dot x, and the value of t3 dot x is 30. Let me make comment line over here so that I can able to run the following code. So this both programs are related with the object as a function argument. The last program of today's session is called friend function, and that is very much important program because it may ask in the 5-mark questions in the exam. Example of friend function include two header files, iostream dot h and conio dot h. Now I'm going to create one class name called test1. I'm going to make one public method, void get data1 cout / n inside test1 over here I am going to use friend void display. One more class I am going to create, that is test2. Again public void get data to cout \n inside test2 friend void display. Now void display cout. This is very easy program, just a bit lengthy. Common function for both classes. Then void main clrscr and get ch. We need to create object of test1 class. Again need to create test2 class t1 and t2. Now t1 dot get data 1 and t2 dot get data 2 and then display. Let me save the program first. Program number 31. Now let me explain. See, when there is a requirement to create two classes, over here we can take test1 and test2, right? Both the class have their own personal or private method called getData1 and getData2. So suppose if I want to access getData1, in such cases I need to create object of test1 class. Similarly, suppose I want to create if I want to access getData2, in such cases I can call the with the help of object of test2 class. So this is the general logic which we have already applied in all our previous programs. But over here we have used the concept of friend function. What is the friend function? What is the use of friend function? See, consider the situation where you want to create one common function which is part of test function as well as test2. Right, these both classes can access whatever the task or role of display function. So what you need to do, you just need to declare void display inside test1 and you need to write keyword friend over here. Similarly, in the class test2 also I have declared that my property is what, void display, and I need to make it as a friend function. So now what happens when I am going to develop the structure of void display, which would be outside both the classes? Over here I have declared void display and inside that some message I have written, nothing else, right? Now what happens, see, I have created object of test1 class as well as I have created object of test2 class, but with the help of t1 and t2 I am able to access getData1 and getData2. But what about if I want to call the display function? See, remember one thing, display is neither the part of, see, it is declared as a friend. So you cannot call it with the help of test2 class or with the help of test1 class, because it is not the personal property of t1 or as well as t2. So you can directly call like normal function call like this, display. You can directly call it, but T1 object cannot claim that display is my function. Similarly, T2 object cannot claim that display is my function because it is declared as a common function. As and when required, it will definitely call it. So let me run the given code. T1.getData inside test1, T2.getData will print inside test2, and with the help of display function, it is common function for both classes. So in this way, program is executed. So this is all about our today's session. In our today's session, we have learned three concepts: array of object as a function argument, and friend function. Let me share the notepad files for the programs so that you can write it in the journal. This is the first program of our today's session, that is array of object. As I have told you, that only the difference between declaration of normal object and array of object is what? When you use the concept of array of object, in such cases the values of object should be stored in the continuous memory allocation. Only the changes is over here at the time of function call. Sorry, one more thing I have forgot, that suppose the size of array of object is of 2. So in the C language we are able to store 0, 1 and 2. But when you call e3.getData, at that time in the C language it will generate the error that you can array index out of bound, right? You cannot store array value more than the size of array. But in the C++, it allows you to access the elements of array, and you are able to store the more than the capacity of array. So e3.getData, you can call it and you can use it. You can call function more than the size of array. Such thing cannot be possible with the C language. Let me scroll down. First of all, this is the first program. Then let me scroll down up to void display. And at last get ch. So this thing is you need to write in the journal, that you can size and you can call with the more than the capacity of array. Second program of our today's session, object as a function argument. We are going to pass the object as a function argument. If you don't want to take integer variable over here, at that time you can directly pass the value of m1 and m2 by 70 70. Such thing can be possible. This is the second program. Third program, object as a function argument. Number 2, we have created class test. Over here t1.x equals to 20 and t2.x equals to 10, and the output is going to store with the help of t3 object. Let me scroll down up to the bracket. And the last program of our today's session, that is friend function, the function which you want to make it common for the both the classes. That function you can make it with the help of friend keyword. But remember one thing, it is directly called like normal UDF. You cannot call it by the test object T1 or test 2 object T2. Let us scroll down. So this is all from my side. Thank you all.